Hello, Hemo friends, and welcome to this new episode of the Longsword Beginner's Guide. Today, we are going to learn our first action on tempo, which will let us defend and attack at the same time. Without further chats, let's start. To build up our first action on tempo, we will learn three different actions. The first two are parry and riposte, because in this specific case, our action on tempo is simply a parry and riposte without any delay between the two actions. So, we will start by learning a very long movement and we will end with the shortest one. Every one of these actions is meant to counter a mandrit offended. So, our first parry and riposte works like this. We parry in frontale and we riposte with a high left thrust. It's pretty simple. Use our standard body mechanics, which I presented you in the fourth episode, to land the parry in frontale. Then, from the position you reach, go high and forward with your hands, thrusting toward the opponent's face, neck or chest. This action doesn't need a specific footwork. You can either keep your position or move your left foot slightly toward the left to gain a bit of leverage in the parry. So, this is our basic form of the action. Let's make it faster. Instead of parrying in a proper frontale, we already move our sword 45 degrees toward the target to shorten our thrusting movement. This comes at a cost, of course. We need to be more precise in our parry action to not endanger our hands. The position we reach in the parry is called left posta di finestra. As you may notice, from this position our riposte is faster as soon as our parry is correct. In this situation, we can, again, do our parry from our position as before, with a good body rotation toward the incoming blow. Okay, let's do our last step, even if in this case maybe it's more a jump than a step. Let's make our action a proper action in tempo. In tempo, in Italian, means on time, so we need to land our offensive action, the thrust, during the execution time of the opponent's blow. So we need even more precision than before, both in the form and in the timing. Fabrizio, as before, strikes his fendente toward me. This time, instead of focusing my attention on the act of defending, I think about landing my thrust. This is a mind trick which will help you landing the action. Focus yourself on the goal of hitting the opponent. While doing so, you move toward a position that covers you with the forte and the crossguard. To help yourself reaching that position, you may move your back foot toward the right and back. This will let you gain a better angle and enough space to land your action safely. When you start the practice of this last action, the action on tempo, start really, really slow, and then increase the speed gradually, to better learn where and when your sword should be in relation to your body, to save yourself from an ugly double hit. Okay guys, here we are with our first action on tempo. In the next episode, we will learn how to defend ourselves from a series of cuts. Remember guys, if you want to support this channel, subscribe to it and check the link of my Patreon page in the video description. A huge amount of exclusive training videos and articles awaits you. Thanks for watching guys, and as always, see you next time.